we also had the women do nipple self-stimulation. And according to the Penfield map, the nipple stimulation should activate the thoracic region, the chest area, which it does. But the big surprise to me was that it also activated the genital, exactly, it activated the genital region of the sensory cortex. It right overlapped with a clitoral, vaginal, cervical area that was activated. The nipple stimulation activated the same thing. And maybe that's why women say that nipple stimulation feels erotic, because it's activating the same neurons. Genital orgasm is, I think, a special case of something that the nervous system is just built to do. I think there are other kinds of orgasmic processes. If you think of orgasm as a buildup of excitation to a peak and some new activity that comes out of it, and then a resolution, then I think that a sneeze is a form of orgasm. Building up the excitation, and then a sudden motor activity release, and then a resolution. And it feels pleasurable. It feels pleasurable to sneeze. But also a yawn, yawning and stretching. These are all the same form of gradual buildup of excitation to some climax, to a peak, even though it's not as intense as during genital orgasm. But I think that our nervous systems are designed to do that, to have those kinds of actions. At orgasm, the similarities between men and women orgasm are much greater than any differences that we see. You see, all the same areas are activated in men and women. The big difference, though, is right after orgasm, when men go into a refractory period, and what we see there is that if the genital self-stimulation continues, it doesn't produce activation of the brain. There's very little response to the stimulation, in contrast to women, who can continue. So that's the big difference that we see. Started with the Kinsey report in 1953, the sexual response in the human female. What they claimed that the vagina and cervix are insensate. In other words, women don't report feeling it. They tried two different types of stimuli on the clitoris, vagina, and cervix. They tried light cotton, and they tried pressure. They had a probe where they applied pressure. And they tested more than 800 women. There was very little response to cotton, to the cotton wisp. When they used pressure, clitoris, vagina, or cervix, more than 80% of the women said they could feel it. How they came to the conclusion that the vagina and cervix is insensate, it doesn't make any sense. But that got into the literature. That got into the media and the common knowledge in the medical profession. The medical profession now, most of the practitioners think that they believe that. That's the way it is. We're seeing that women, there's a procedure called the LEEP procedure, L-E-E-P. So that's an acronym for women who have cervical cancer. The procedure is to scoop out with electric cautery to scoop out the core of the cervix, and the women say that they lose after that procedure they lose sexual response. So you know, we're just collecting data on that. It seems to be a fairly common report, and obviously there's we don't know what the effect of that on the innervation is. That's one of the things that we want to look at. But since there are three different pairs of nerves that carry sensation from the cervix, and those are damaged. They have to be damaged when the whole tissue is removed. And that has, apparently, it has very profound effects on women's, not only the sexual response, but also the libido. So this is something that is certainly not appreciated by the medical profession. They certainly, the women say that their doctors don't tell them anything about the possible consequence of doing this. So we're trying to first get the information from the women, and then tell the medical profession about this. They have to be knowledgeable about it. I mean, infants spend a lot of time correlating the appearance, the visual with the physical, and the taste. It sounds poetic, but maybe it's really based on very physiological things. When we talk about heavy-hearted or light-hearted or broken-hearted, hard-hearted, all these expressions, maybe the sensations from our heart really influence our mood. We just don't have the ability to, you know, it's not like seeing a hand. It's hard to make the connection. It's hard to learn the connection between the feeling and where it's coming from for our internal organs. And it's probably true of the cervix. So I think that's why you have to learn what your cervix feels like.